scripture or two that will give you a guidance about family.
Yes, important.
One, give me Proverbs 17:14. NIV. No, give me 15:18, please. 15:18. Proverbs 15:18, please.
Midari 15.
1, 2, 3. Everyone read with me. 1, 2, 3, please. A hot-tempered man
has a dissension, but a patient man comes a quarrel.
Read it again. 1, 2, 3. A hot-tempered man stirs up dissension, but a patient man comes a quarrel. Amen. Men, priests in the year 2017, deal with your hot temperedness. Avoid a temper in your family. And your family will be strong. In Jesus' name. Proverbs 21 verse 9. Proverbs 21 verse 9. 1, 2, 3, read with me. 1, 2, 3. Better to live in a corner
of the room than share a house with a poor woman.
Read it again. 1, 2, 3.
Better to live in a corner of the room than share a house with a poor woman.
Priest, wives, are all the ladies. Read it alone. 1, 2, 3.
We
don't want quarrels in our home.
You know, this scripture is amazing. It is
better to live on a corner of a roof. You are not living in the roof.
No.
Not living in the roof. No. See, a corner.
With
a quarrel someone.
Namke ambaye ni wa manganano ugomvi.
Please, I beseech you women. Please, you women, you mothers.
Oh mama.
You ladies.
Wadada.
Stop quarrels.
Wacheni na ugomvi.
Some of you have quarreled your husbands away from home.
Wengine mmetoa ugomvi kwa mume wako mpaka mmemtoa nyumbani.
I'm telling you the truth.
Nakwambia ukweli.
Is this the Bible?
Hii ni andiko liko kwa Biblia.
You know, if you're not saying amen, I'll give you another scripture. So you better say amen. Hii maneno tumalizane ikwishe. Tumalizane ikwishe hapa. Ukinyamaza nitaendelea na hii.
Ukinyamaza itaendelea.
Bwana sifi, tukubali yaishe. Let us better to live on a corner of the roof.
Afadhali kuishi kwenye kona ya
share a house.
Badala ya kushiriki nyumba.
Sharing a house.
Kushiriki nyumba, kuishi nyumba moja.
You know, by the time quarrels come, there is no longer any marriage. It's like sharing a house.
What?
You unarealize hakuna haja ya hii nyumba.
Mbana, wanakuwa tu wakishiriki tu kuishi kwa nyumba moja.
Munangangana tu kuishi.
Muna survive.
There will be no surviving this year. Your marriage will have peace in Jesus' mighty name.
Kwa na amani hakuna kusurvive.
Amen.
Amen.
Bwana tukuzwe sana.
Bwana tukuzwe.
And I want to say thank you.
Na ningependa kusema asante
to my wife.
Kwa mke wangu.
She has not allowed me to live in the corner of a roof.
Amen. Hajanifanya niishi katika kona ya paa.
She has not been quarrelsome. That one I can tell you without any fear of contradiction.
Hiyo naweza kukwambia bila shaka.
She has not been quarrelsome.
Hajakuwa mwenye ugomvi.
Amen.
Amen.
And Manasseh is here. Ephraim is there.
Manasseh yuko hapa. Ephraim
is there. They can tell you whether there are quarrels in our home.
Wanaweza waambia kama kumekuwa na ugomvi katika nyumba yetu.
Have there been quarrels? Have there been quarrels? Are there quarrels at home? Okay. In fact, let me tell you the truth. These kids have never seen us quarrel. For the last 20, since they were born, 25 years, 24 years ago.
Hawajawahi ona tukigombana.
They have never seen, not even once.
Hata mara moja.
Thank you. Tupigie makofi Bwana kwani unasikia vipi? May the same blessing come upon your family.
Amen.
I say may the same blessing come upon your family and your marriage. The house of worship, and we believe in families. And may that happen in Jesus' name. Amen. And because you don't want for me to continue with that, let me stop because I see nikiendelea na hiyo maneno. Naweza pigwa mawe hapa tu nikifikiria ni
rushwa hapa
kipi hapa ninacheza. Bwana asifiwe.
Bwana asifiwe.
Dada, Bwana asifiwe. Give me Proverbs 19:19.
Midari 19:19.
Okay, pastor. Watch out for the Proverbs 19:19. Watch out for the 19:19. Proverbs 19:19. Let me just summarize it up.
Idari kumnati sa kumnati.
Lakini ni takuwa yako. Lakini. Are you there? Proverbs 19:19. Ah. Read with me. 1, 2, 3.
A hot-tempered man must pay the penalty. If you rescue him, you will have to do it again.
That is
19:19.
Proverbs 19:19. A hot-tempered man must pay the penalty. If you rescue him, after ukimtoa kwa mtolea bibia,
au kumlipia tena.
Eh? That's Proverbs 19:19. Huh? Si Mungu atusaidie.
Mungu atusaidie.
Pata tupata tumaidisi ya kwa hiyo mwini. Sawa. Now. Lift up your hands, say, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Spirit of quarrel.
Spirit of quarrel.
Get out of my life.
Get out of my life.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Somebody say 2017.
2017.
Hear the word of the Lord.
Hear the word of the Lord.
No quarrels.
No quarrels.
Only.
Only.
Divine revelation.
Divine revelation.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus'
name. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Pia bwana makofi kwa sababu ya hayo machache. Asante, asante, asante. Bwana say, I have tried to be very balanced between the men and the women. Nisionekane, I am biased.
Nimejaribu kuweka usawa kati ya waume na wake ili nisionekane kama naegemea upande mmoja.
Amen. Now, this week we went for the apostolic visit with our fathers.
Kaka matembezi ya
we were gathered in the Deliverance Church Uplands.
Tulikuwa tumekutana katika kanisa
la Mungu. We had over 1000 people attending from this week.
Tulikuwa na watu zaidi ya 1000 wakihudhuria,
pastors and leaders of churches.
Wachungaji na viongozi
from this church we went a number of us.
Kutoka kanisa hili tulienda baadhi yetu.
If you are with us in Uplands, why don't you stand up?
Kama ulikuwa pamoja nasi Uplands, simama.
Very fast please.
Baraka
kibia hapa, those who went with us in Uplands. Kapanya ni haraka.
Why you lead the Uplands?
Those who went to Uplands, thank you for coming, choosing to go there. I had told you all of us and I invited all of us to go, but these are the people who went. Including mom, you are there. You are writing scripture, Proverbs. Okay. This is the team that we went with. Wapatie kipaza sauti mtu aseme kitu moja alipata kutoka dakika moja tu.
So in this year of divine elevation, you know kwamba it's a process. And when God speaks to you, anakwambiaga I will elevate you. Aliambia Joseph ya kwamba he's going to be great. The land wazazi wake watakuja ku bow to him. Kumwambia ni before wabawa to him atapitia jera, atauzwa literally atauzwa hata bila nguo. I remember, yes. So there is a process for you to get there, and so it is the time for us to rise in prayer even as we get elevated.
Amen.
Amen.
Mama atamalizia hoja ayapatia hawa.
Thanks God. I learned when I went there is that God's own our land. That was the topic that this year that you shall own the property regardless of the any witchcraft that is set against you not to achieve whatever you are like. You're gonna receive it in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen. Thank you.
Amen. Yeah, the word says, see, I have set thee over all the land. So Joseph alienda Egypt akiwa kama property. But at the end of it all, he became the owner of the property. That's what I learned.
Amen.
Bishop concentrated so much on the land. Akatuambia this year we shall receive a land, church land, our personal land. Na akasema mtu akikuja kukwambia anapitia kashamba mahali usiseme huna pesa. Then nikakumbuka nikashika sana at the time Bishop was beginning, alisema we do not focus on the elevation, we should focus on the one who is elevating us. So what I concentrate na mungu wetu this year, na akasema vile, the another point Bishop was explaining how Joseph alitolewa kwa jela haraka haraka na maisha kwa haraka haraka. Akatwambia, when the time for elevation come, itakuwa haraka haraka. And last week, kuna kitu moja walisema, and it is a request, you know, it's a command because it came from my father. Akasema, kuna siri moja tu ya elevation. Kuna mtu anataka kujua kuelevetiwa siri yake ni nini this year?
Yeah.
Alisema siri ni moja tu, we honor our father. Tukaambiwa kama bishop, from as the one as a command from our bishop, if we want any elevation in your life this year, we must honor our father. Na akasema tukienda church, tujipange kama mama, kama wanayuni, kama watoto, every department wajipange vile wataona our parents, the house. Na akasema even as an individual level, mpange na uandike ile kitu utaona your father with. Na akasema ikuwe haraka sana sababu kama unataka kuelevetiwa tutaipangia December. Akasema hii si yenye tunafanyaga each and every year. Akasema uifanye haraka iwezekanavyo ndio tuende. Na tulipewa kanda na I believe our dad will tell us more on it na vile tutafanya. Na akasema please 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 make sure you need elevation, you need to honor our parents. God bless you.
Amen. What has you?
Amen.
Yes, it was a wonderful meeting. Among many things, I was touched by the testimony of the First Lady of the Deliverance Church. That lady over there, Mom Joyce. I don't know whether I'm allowed to say this, yeah?
Yeah, you're allowed anything.
Yeah. Alisema, alienda, tulikuwa Deliverance Church applicants. Aliendaga hiyo church, kabla hajiolewa na bishop. So, in her own words, she said, alienda kwa hiyo church akuwa nobody. As in, akuna mse ange, ange mrecognize kami, na kita mrecognize haina mrespect. So, but she was received so well there, and she's, I think she went to minister or something, but she said she went and she was appreciated by a token, a kapewa bahasha. So, and then, she said she was so touched by that act. Na akasema hata hiyo pesa yenye alipewa alinunua Bible. And so she was so humbled by the pastors of that church for receiving her even while she was a nobody. Now we went. The pastors there have put a very nice sanctuary, but hijabal tiles. And out of that act, Mom Joyce gave them 100,000 for putting the tiles. Out of, I unexpectedly, I was touched by that and gave 100,000 for the project and tiles in church. Now, it didn't stop there. At the mention of that, you know now pastors in your Kwapo, yeah? Congregation Kai Yote ni ma pastors, yeah? Of 100 church years in Nairobi South. Now, of course, pastors, they are sharp in the spirit. So, upon saying 100,000, what do you kind of pledge? 50, 30, 10. Within no time, we were 1 point something million.
1.15
yeah? 1.15 million.
1,015,000.
Yeah, 1,015,000. Out of nowhere. You only by the way, when you're a million twin at okay in you. So I think that above many other things it touched me and it helped me to desire to respect people, to receive people, to treasure people whoever they are. And I think for me it is the year of divine elevation and I know I'm being elevated in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. And just to put some season on what Manasseh has said, of course you know Evrede Gekwa. You mentioned giving, you spoil him.
Yeah.
Amen. So among the people who prayed, he was among them. And there and then he paid his bread and he showed me the receipt. Amen. Hapo hapo. Kabla watu wanasema 58 tayari zake alipray na amezitoa Bwana asifiwe sana. And I thank God for his spirit. And that is why the house of worship and healing, we are going far.
Amen.
Amen. Now, I was just climaxing what Manasseh was saying. What touched me in that congregation, it is about giving. That one goes without saying. Kasema ya kwamba, if you want to be elevated, you must be a giver. And I decided I'm going to be a giver this year more than I've ever been. Because there is no way to be elevated if wewe ni mkono gamu. If you are not a tither, mama elevation, hiyo tuachie. Bwana asifiwe sana. Amen. If you are not a giver, kama wewe ni ule mtu mzee anasikia kumeitishwa kitu kanisani unaanza kunugunika ukisema ya kwamba hii kanisa ni pesa na mambo kama yale, mambo ya elevation hata usitaje. Just watch us. Tuko pamoja. Wewe tutizame tukifanya nini? Tukiinuliwa kwa sababu Mungu si adhumani, ni mwaminifu na anaraki na deni ya mtu. Bwana asifiwe sana. Not once, not twice, I have seen my husband giving. Na within seconds, ananionyesha, imerudi. Are we together? Anapanda tu, kitu, maybe kitu imesema hivyo. But within seconds, imepando. Actually, I value you, inapando ikiwa imejumuli. Imejumulisho because Mungu wetu si muongo. Bwana asifiwe sana. Naye si mwizi, naye si maskini. Akaagi na kakikombe hapa kwa barabara akisema saidia maskini. Yeye ndiye anaye miliki kila kitu. Anataka imani yako aichokore ndiye akubariki. Na hakuna jinsi atakubariki kama wewe haujajifunza kupea. He started by giving his son. One thing I learned about the entire visit is that Joseph purposed in his heart to remain righteous. He was tempted in the area of immorality, but he decided to remain righteous. And through his righteousness, he was punished by being put to prison. Of course, he had no sin. He had no reason why he was to be put to the prison. But because he stood in the righteousness, he was punished because of being righteous. And because of being righteous, he was elevated. I want to say to the house of worship and healing, for us to enter into great elevation, righteousness must be your garment. And I repeat again, righteousness must be your garment. Remember, God watches even what you are thinking. God watches what you speak in the inside. Hata tusikii kile unasema, but God hears that which you are speaking in your mind or in your spirit. I want to encourage us. Let us remain righteous before God. Not before your wife, not before your parents, but remain righteous before God for divine elevation. God bless you.
Amen. Asante. Wapigeni makofi. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Bring that card. I will tell you later about these cards that that Bishop had, but not today. Amen. Is on that.
Ngependa kutilia mkazo.
Amen.
Amen.
Because every year,
kila mwaka,
the children of Israel, they went back to Shiloh.
Wana wa Israeli walirudi Shiloh.
Because Shiloh was an altar.
Manake Shiloh ilikuwa
where they delight their life and their blessing.
Ambapo walitoa uhai wako na wao na baraka.
Now, when we are doing prayer and fasting,
wakati ambapo tunafanya maombi ya kuomba na kufunga,
by the time we are through and we are finishing,
wakati ambapo tunakuwa tumaliza,
normally
kwa kawaida,
we are encouraged to give a sacrifice.
Tuna sihiwa kutoa dhabihu.
Every year we do that.
Kila mwaka ufanya hivyo.
When we go for our national prayers and fasting in the beginning of the year,
tunapoenda maombi ya kuomba,
the first week,
mwaka,
we go, we pray and fast.
Tunaenda tunaomba na kufunga.
And on the last day, we give a sacrifice for ourselves, our children, and our churches, which I always and gradually do. Why? I know that there is power in sacrifice. How many are with me until now?
Now,
I want you to understand that when you see things going on in your life, there is somebody who always believe in God for you. That is why we are called servants of God. That is why we are spiritual fathers. That's why we are spiritual Lord. I am very careful what I do as a result of the church and the people God have entrusted to us. And I connect the church to the flow of the anointing from our fathers. I don't want this church to miss the blessings of God. How many are with me? Blessed be the name of the Lord. So we normally do that. And I also encourage that as we do prayer and fasting, by the time we are finishing, we give a sacrifice. But this year, we will connect our annual sacrifice with the honor. Because bishops say all the churches in Kenya must come together and honor their pastors.
And after
they bring their honor, the tithe of the honor they bring will go to Bishop Mark. Now I feel we need to do that by March or
April.
I will read it. Monica was there, she will read it, and then there will be men, there will be women, there will be youth, and all of us as a church we will organize that issue. And we need to do it as early as possible so that we may have the rest of the year. Because if we organize that by November, December, the year is already. If we do it by March, April, we shall have the rest of 8 months to see what God will do.
Are you getting
how many are with me?
So
now we organize it as a church and we do it
together.
We want good organization. We want honor to be honored. In Jesus' name. Is that good?
Yes.
Is that good?
Yes.
Are you getting it?
Yes.
Now, let me go straight to the word because I have about 45 minutes to finish the service. Did you bring your Bible? Before that, turn to your neighbor, ask them, by the way, what is your name? Ask them, by the way, what is your name? Mwambie ni muhimu kujua neighbor wangu. Mwana sifiwe. Get to know your neighbor.
Your jirani.
Have fellowship with them. Ask them, how was your week?
Muulize week imekuwa aje.
Muulize hii mambo ya divine elevation. Unaona tunaenda wapi?
Ya divine elevation.
Muulize unaona tunaelekea wapi?
Unaelekea wapi?
Let me also declare.
Na wacha pia nitangaze.
This coming week from tomorrow.
Wiki hii ijayo.
Today after service in the evening we shall have a Holy Spirit experience evening.
Leo baada ya ibada tutakuwa na kipindi cha kukua na Roho Mtakatifu.
We shall have a moment of worship.
Tutakuwa na wakati wa ibada.
From tomorrow through Friday evening prayers.
Kutoka kesho hadi Ijumaa maombi ya jioni.
And all the week we are doing fasting.
Na wiki yote tutafanya kufunga.
Let me say something about fasting.
What does it make you to kuhusu kufunga?
Fasting does not change God.
Kufunga hakubadilishi Mungu.
Fasting changes you.
Kufunga kunakubadilisha wewe.
Please get that.
Pata hiyo tafadhali.
Fasting si kushika Mungu mkono. Namwambia Mungu, nimekwambia unipe. That is what people think.
Even if you want to know
that fasting is, I'm twisting God.
Yeah, come on, come
on, come on. That is not what fasting is. Fasting does not change God. It changes you. It makes your spirit man to become strong. So that you can command spiritual authority. And this week we are this morning I was teaching about the levels of prayer between asking and saying. This week we are saying, we are making decree. And our focus will be the church. Bishop spoke so much about land. I am believing God for the land of the house of worship and healing. We had begun a project towards owning land, but this year we are going to revive it. Immediately we are through with honoring the pastors, then we shall start a project. project for the land.
Tutaanza mradi wa kununua shamba.
Because I know God will help us.
Manake najua Mungu atatusaidia.
We are staying on a leased ground. This ground is leased.
Tuko katika mahali ambapo tumekodi.
And we have been here for 8 years.
Na tumekuwa hapa miaka.
And we pay a lot of money.
Na tunalipa pesa nyingi.
But it is time God give us our own.
Lakini wakati
I say it is time God give us our own.
Mungu atatupatia yetu.
He can give us this one.
Anaweza tupa hii.
Because the earth and the fullness thereof
to God. Manake ardhi na vyote vilivyomo ni vyake.
Are you believing with me?
Yes.
So this week we are praying for the church. Pray for the land, for the house of God. Pray for our sanctuary. Pray for us. Pray for me.
Ombea mchungaji.
Pray for us. We need your prayer.
Tuombe. Tunahitaji maombi yetu.
Amen. That we shall hear God clearly. That we shall receive divine protection.
In whatever we do.
Let's pray for this church. Pray for deliverance church. And the body of Christ. So this week we are dedicating to prayer for the church.
Okay, that is done.
Did you bring your Bible? Let me see it if you brought
it.
If you don't have, don't worry. You just lift up your right hand. But you need to be to buy a Bible. You heard Mom Joyce when she went to Apra many years ago. She was honored with an emblem, and she thought, "What can I do with this man?" She bought a Bible.
I cannot know a Bible.
That Bible later on was to make her to be married to Bishop Mark.
Biblia hiyo baadaye ilimfanya akaolewe na Askofu Mark.
Amen.
Amen.
And as a way of thanksgiving, she said, "I am giving 100,000 towards putting tithes in your church."
Yeah, shukrani akasema na.
The Bible is everything you need.
Biblia ndio.
I said the Bible is everything you need.
Biblia ndio kila kitu tunachohitaji.
Bwana tukuzwe sana. Now lift up your hand, say, "This is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
I love it.
I love
it. It has changed my life.
Changed my life.
And this moment, I open my spirit.
I open my spirit
to receive, the ever living, incorruptible, seed of the Word of God. I'm ready for my miracle, and I'm ready for change. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Before I bring the word, let me request you. Let me plead. Let me beseech you. If you want me to kneel for you, I will kneel.
Kama mnataka nipige magoti nitapiga.
But I want to persuade you.
Lakini ningependa kuwasihi.
Please,
tafadhali.
Please,
tafadhali.
Let us avoid the culture of coming to church late.
Wacha tuepukane na mtindo wa kuja kanisani tumechelewa.
This service begins at 9.
Ibada hii inaanza saa
9. And we finish by 12.
Na tunamaliza saa 6.
Please,
tafadhali.
Have it in your mind. Every Sunday morning when you are going to church,
kila Jumapili unapoenda kanisani,
you are not going for a walk.
Hauendi matembezi.
You are not going to a restaurant.
Hauendi kwenye.
You have an appointment with Jehovah.
Na mwaliko na Jehovah.
And you must be on time.
Na ni lazima uwe katika muda unaofaa.
Please,
tafadhali.
If we do that,
tukifanya hivi,
by 9 we are seated the way we are seated all of us.
Saa 3 tunakuwa tumekaa bila baba zote tumeketi.
If we honor God by keeping time to be in his house.
Tukiheshimu Mungu kwa kutumisha muda katika nyumba yake.
If we realize God watches over us when we are coming to his house.
Tukigundua kwamba Mungu anatizama tunapofika kanisani.
This year will be the best year of your life.
Mwaka huu utakuwa mwaka mzuri wa maisha.
God does not bless anything that is done half-heartedly.
I have never said that. Mungu hakubariki kitu chochote ambacho kinafanya moyo nusu-nusu.
Please, I beseech you.
Now,
nine is not a road to demand that by 9:30 all of us we are seated and ready for the service.
Saa tatu sio kwamba ni jambo ngumu kwako kutenda kwamba unakuwa umeketi ukingoja kusikiza neno.
And then we have 3 hours of service, you go where you want.
Unakuwa na masaa matatu ya neno.
I repeat, I beseech you, I persuade you,
nawaomba,
I appeal, I request, I cry to you.
Now, hallelujah.
Please, I beseech you.
Now, see.
Workers, there is no reason why you should not be here by 8.
Sababu kwa nini
every morning, 8.
Kila
many of you are supposed to be here by 7.
Wengine
mnapaswa 7:30. But latest, you should be here by 8.
Lakini
kichelewa. Let us honor God with time.
Tuheshimu Bwana na
matenda. Tell the neighbor, redeem time.
Redeem time.
For the days are evil.
For the days are
evil. Turn to somebody, tell them, redeem time.
Time.
For the days are evil.
For the days are evil.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
How many are with me?
Wangapi tuko pamoja?
I beseech you. That one I can do anything to have you do that.
Naweza fanya chochote ili muweze kuitenda.
In Jesus' name.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
Bwana asifiwe sana. Some of my training is in pastorship. I did it in Malaysia. I went to Malaysia, MTI, Ministry Training Institute in Malaysia. The Malaysian church, they have ordained, they are the disciples of the Korean church.
Kanisa la Malaysia,
and they are things they do. One, they keep time in their services. Wanadumisha
muda katika ibada zao.
If a service begins at 8,
kama ibada inaanza saa 2,
by 6 in the morning people are full in the church.
Then ashara asubuhi watu wamejaa kanisani.
And they take not less than 2 hours of prayer before the big service begins.
Na wanachukua sio chini ya masaa mawili kuomba kabla ibada ianze.
A service that begins at 8, people are in church at 6 praying.
Ibada inaanza saa 2, watu wako na ashara kanisani wakiomba.
Bwana asifiwe sana.
Bwana asifiwe.
And as a result, those people are very prophetic and very blessed.
Na kwa sababu hiyo wale watu wamebarikiwa.
Let us be a church with a difference.
Tuwe kanisa lenye utofauti.
How many are with me? Blessed be the name of the Lord. That is that. Last Sunday,
Jumapili iliyopita,
I shared with us,
nilishiriki nasi,
10 things that I believe God is going to do for us in the year 2017, in the year of divine elevation.
Ambao ninaamini Mungu atatutendea katika mwaka 2017, mwaka wa kuinuliwa.
Number one, we say in the year 2017,
tukasema,
God will do what? You shall be celebrated.
Utasherekewa.
In other words,
na maneno mengine,
just like Joseph became a celebrity,
kama vile Yusufu alifanyika kusherekewa,
this year,
mwaka huu,
I decree by the Spirit of the Lord,
natangaza kwa Roho,
you shall be celebrated.
Utasherekewa.
In your career, in your family, in your marriage, in your place of work,
ndoa, katika mahali pa kazi,
you have celebrated others.
Umesherekea wengine.
This year you shall be celebrated.
Mwaka huu utasherekewa.
You are not hearing me. This year you shall be celebrated.
Mwaka huu utasherekewa.
You are in the year 27. Number two, things that God will do in the year 2017. Number two, you shall be decorated. The year 2017, you shall be decorated. For Joseph, they put in him a golden link, a royal robe, and a golden chain. This year, you shall be decorated in Jesus' name. Your family shall be decorated. Your children shall be decorated. You shall be decorated in your presence. Number three, things that God will do. You shall be recognized.
Utatambulika.
Those who have been ignoring you, your time to be ignored is over in Jesus' name.
Wakati wa kupuuza umepita katika jina la
Yesu. I even went further and I said, somebody will call you.
Kuna mtu atakupigia.
Because for a long time you have not heard from them.
Maana kwa muda mrefu hujasikia kutoka kwao.
They will ask you, where are you?
Watakuuliza uko wapi?
Did that happen or not? He came to tell me.
Alikuja kuniambia.
Kuja. Kuja. Huyu. Ujue kama unajua we don't waste time.
Hatupotee.
When we speak words, we don't waste time.
Tunaponena.
1 minute. Can you tell us?
Hello, Bwana asifiwe. Amen. There is a certain email that I've been sending somewhere, and I've been waiting for some emails from people. So when pastor said about it, nikaandika kwa notebook, kata nilikuwa namuonyesha. I wrote it in my notebook. Akasema, on Tuesday somebody will call you for a cup of coffee at Java. So I wrote exactly.
How many remember the cup of G at Java? It came to pass.
That's what I wrote.
To cut a whole story short, huyu jamaa kwa university, he is in Kemu, Nairobi. He is the chairman of the Christian Union. And somebody sponsored him for his course. They went for an intern. Okay, what are you saying? You are not coming to say my report.
Yes, sawa. So what I did on Monday, nikapata email. Nikapata email. Ikisema, please send me your phone number. I'm in Kenya. I landed yesterday evening. So nika send my phone number. So on Tuesday, she called me. She's from Germany. She called me and she asked me, where can we meet? Can you choose a place in town where we can meet? And kasema, wow, now the Java has come. So because I have never been in one of the Javas around, I looked for a very nice hotel somewhere, and I met the person, and the balance that I was having for the school fees, she said that she's going to clear everything to
me. Amen. So, somebody will call you. The calling is still going on. This is the power of this week in Jesus' mighty name. Number four.
Empowered.
You will be empowered. In the year 2017, you shall be empowered. You shall operate in higher spiritual authority. Number five. You will be rewarded. Bwana asifiwe. May you be rewarded in your place of work, in your business, in your career, in whatever you do. May you be rewarded. In the work you have done for God, some of you have been faithful in your tithing, in your offering. You have served God faithfully in this church. May God reward you. Hebrews 11:6. God is a faithful rewarder. God is a rewarder. God is a
rewarder.
You know, you people, some of you don't want, you wonder how we serve this God. We serve God because we know He is a rewarder. May you be rewarded this year. Number six. You shall be clothed. I say you shall be
be clothed. This year you shall not suffer nakedness. You shall be clothed in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Number? The other one, you shall be? You shall be recommissioned. Remember, our divine elevation is through the gospel. And we are recommissioned to go out and win souls. Please be a soul winner this year. I want an evangelistic team that is going to rise up. Soul winners, people will be saved. Every twice a month, we shall be going out and do soul winning.
What about the
door to door, person to person? By now, you don't need Pastor Kiko to organize you to go and win souls. You can do it yourself. Let me get people with a zeal for who know I am recommissioned. Do I have people here who believe they are called in the ministry?
Yes.
Do I have people here who believe God will take them to Asia, India, to go and preach the gospel, yes, to Germany, yes, to Chile, South America, yes, who believe they have a national calling that they will go to the nations of the world because of the gospel. What? Do I have such people?
Wait,
do I have such people? Yeah. Then it starts by preaching the gospel to that your neighbor. It starts by telling that you are neighbor, you are deskmate, you are workmate, you are classmate about Jesus. And going standing here in Wanye Road and people who are passing telling them Jesus loves you, we welcome you to church. And making sure every week you invite somebody to come to church. And you don't want to come alone. Every Sunday you ensure you bring somebody. The way we are seated here, if we become aggressive with preaching the gospel, this church can double